Hello friend, welcome to Henchman Engineering Consulted Private Limited. We are trusted supporter with sole motto of strategize, organize, globalize. Today the subject we will discuss is lime kiln mass balance and energy calculations. Why we have chosen this subject is because once you know the subject thoroughly or all the gamut of the subject, then you can contribute something innovative and transformational. This innovation can be radical or incremental, doesn't matter. But definitely, once you know the subject, you can contribute something very, very important. So, objective is this video is to prepare student, novice, and other professional to learn the stoichiometry. Stoichiometry means how much is produced from how much reactant. Though we have prepared this video for student, novice and other professional, but you will find the people who has worked for the year in this lime kiln or lime business, they come to know this video is very, very interesting. So from this video, you will know how to calculate product quality and quantity at different lime purity. What is the theoretical fuel consumption? What should be the optimal fuel consumption? How to calculate lime kiln thermal efficiency? How to calculate radiation heat losses to the kiln surface area? How to calculate heat losses by flue gases? This is a typically grammatically explanation of a rotary lime kiln, how it works. If you will see the reaction, 1 mole of calcium carbonate get converted into 1 mole of calcium oxide and 1 mole of carbon dioxide when heated at temperature 1200 to 1250 degree centigrade. A rotary lime kiln can be as long as 100 meter, having diameter 3.2 meter to up to 4 meter. But friends, as you saw in the previous reaction, 1 mole of calcium carbonate is decomposing into 1 mole of calcium oxide plus 1 mole of carbon dioxide at 1250 degrees centigrade. That reaction is 100% complete and the raw material used was also 100% pure. But actually, no raw material is 100% pure. There are some impurity inherent in it. So is here our raw material also. We have taken such a raw material and tabulated that for your knowledge and for your information. Here the raw material content shows that calcium carbonate content is 97%, magnesium carbonate 1%, acid insoluble 1%, silica 1%. Now see the reaction. Here, suppose 100 gram of calcium carbonate is heated at 1250 degree centigrade. It decomposes into 56 gram of calcium oxide and 44 gram of carbon dioxide. Here, purity will be 100% because reaction is 100% complete, as well as raw material reactant calcium carbonate is also 100% pure. Heat requirement will be 178.4 kilojoule. Now take this reaction. Here 100 gram of reactant is decomposing into 57.32 gram of calcium oxide and 42.68 gram of carbon dioxide. We have taken purity of calcium carbonate as 97%, as we have tabulated in the tabulation, you will see 97% content is of calcium carbonate, remaining is inert. We have assumed that inert is not taking part in the reaction. So even though this reaction is also 100% complete, but you cannot achieve purity more than 94.76%. Here, फ्यूल कंजम्पशन और एनर्जी रिक्वायरमेंट इज 173.0 किलो जूल। नाउ कंसीडर दिस रिएक्शन, हियर इज द सेम रॉ मटेरियल हैविंग कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट कंटेंट 97%। सो यू विल से 100 ग्राम ऑफ कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट इज डीकम्पोजिंग इनटू 61.2 ग्राम ऑफ कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड। दिस 61.2 ग्राम कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड नॉट कंप्लीटली कैल्शियम ऑक्साइड बट इंक्लूड कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट प्लस इनर्ट आल्सो। हियर 3 ग्राम इज इनर्ट, रिमेनिंग इज द कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट। बिकॉज द रिएक्शन इज नॉट 100% कंप्लीट, अलोंग विद 61.2 ग्राम यू विल गेट कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड 68.8 ग्राम। सो हियर एनर्जी रिक्वायरमेंट इज 157.31 एंड प्योरिटी इज 80.5%। दो दिस रिएक्शन इज 91% कंप्लीट बट इवन दो यू कैन नॉट अचीव प्योरिटी मोर देन 80.5%। सो इफ यू नीड टू हैव मोर प्योरिटी यू नीड टू मोर यू हैव टू सप्लाई मोर एनर्जी। नाउ बेस्ड ऑन रिएक्शन नंबर 3 we have chosen a purity 80.5% in rotary lime kiln for its calculations. Why we have chosen 80% efficiency? Because almost all over the globe where rotary lime kiln operate, it instructed that you should maintain purity 80% because in their raw material feed, that is mud, usually contained silica content up to 4%. Some of the mills, those are having more silica, they are operating near about this much purity. Taking in direction into the account, it says 61.2 gram of lime, including make it sure that this 61.2 gram contains calcium carbonate as well as impurity in the product, requires 157.31 kilojoule energy. So 1 metric ton lime will require 2.57 gigajoule energy, or we can say that to produce a metric ton lime produce, energy requirement will be 2.57 gigajoule. So if your lime kiln is utilizing 2.57 gigajoule per metric ton, it is meant that your lime kiln is operating at 100% efficiency. If your lime kiln is utilizing 5.14 gigajoule, it means that your lime kiln is operating at 50% efficiency. Similarly, if your lime kiln is utilizing 11.74 gigajoule for producing a metric ton lime, it is operating at 18.7% efficiency. Energy losses in rotary lime kiln and radiation. Due to radiation and flue gases, radiation losses can be calculated by Stefan Boltzmann law. This is the formula. You put all the data, all the temperature are in kelvins. So we have calculated and find that a kiln having diameter 3.2 meter and 85 meter long of capacity 180 ton per day is radiating losses 3.57 kilowatt per meter square, which means that 1.61 gigajoule per metric ton lime produced. But this radiation losses is expected to be as high as 8 kilowatt per meter square, which means that 3.8 gigajoule per metric lime ton produced. Losses through the flue gases. Flue gases composes of water vapor plus other gases. So by calculating enthalpy at that particular temperature and of water vapor and gases, you can calculate heat losses. When you will calculate, you will find that heat losses through the flue gases is 3.816 gigajoule per metric ton lime produced, which is more than 100% required for to produce a metric ton lime. To produce a metric ton lime. Heat efficiency of rotary lime kiln. We have calculated or taken a study of kiln of capacity 180 metric ton per day. So we have find that to produce a metric ton lime, it requires 380 kg coal as a producer gas along with furnace oil 120 kg. So total energy requirement is 11.74 gigajoule per metric ton lime produced. Oh my god, we find that theoretical fuel consumption is only 2.57 gigajoule per metric ton lime produced. So efficiency of that rotary lime kiln is only 21.8%, which is very very low. Typically, if you see or if you Google throughout the internet, you will find that typical energy requirement to produce a metric ton lime is 4 gigajoule per gigajoule. So typical efficiency should be 64.2%. It means that if you achieve 64% efficiency, you are saving 100% oil plus 155 kg of coal per metric ton lime produced. If you achieve efficiency of 64%, it means that you are able to reduce your product cost. Here product is definitely lime, by a rupee of 5,412 rupees. Not only you will able to reduce the cost, in the same time you will be able to reduce the carbon dioxide also. How? Because the oil and coal you have reduced is equivalent to 780.6 kg per metric ton lime produced. So if your plant or if your industry is producing 350 ton per day lime and at having efficiency of 64%, then it means that you are reducing carbon dioxide equivalent to 99,722 metric ton annually. This was sustainability part or ergonomics of that. And you will see that if you are able to reduce this much CO2, you will be able to save 45,32,800 maturity. How we have calculated that? If you will search and read, you will find that a mature tree absorbs 22 kg of CO2 annually. So indirectly you are reducing load on those tree or saving those tree indirectly. So this was up to sustainability part. Now come to the capital, what an industry can leverage if efficiency is 64%. So we have calculated that if your lime kiln is able to achieve 64% efficiency, then you will be able to save a capital of 69.1 crore annually. Condition that you are producing 350 ton lime per day. Wow, how interesting it is. So a sustainable process can be economical also. Till now we have not seen such lime kiln, because usually it has been seen that no rotary lime kiln has its payback period, because it is producing lime costlier, which can be purchased somewhere else. So we are here not only to witness the change, but also be the change. So friend, this was all about lime kiln mass balance and energy balance. If you have still any doubt, any query, you can mail all your query at the rate of address info@henchman-engineering.com. In the forthcoming slide, we will discuss the technology to curb the radiation losses and heat losses through the flue gases. We will see in the forthcoming video, is there any opportunity or there any innovative idea so that we can produce a lime having lowest silica content and highest purity at a lowest possible cost. So friends, if you like the video, I will request you all to please subscribe and press the bell icon so that such type of innovative video you friend will be able to see by notification in your YouTube. So till then, bye bye.